In this video, I'm going to show you how to install your brand new GeForce RTX 5060 Ti. From start to finish, I'm going to show you how to remove your old graphics card, drivers and all, then install your brand new graphics card, drivers and all, and then show you how to optimize your system for your best performance. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. So before we can actually get the card installed, we're going to want to prepare our system. To prepare it, we'll just open up a Chrome tab or an Edge tab or Firefox, whatever browser you use. Then up here, we'll go to wagnardsoft.com and we're going to download DDU or Display Driver Uninstaller. So we'll just click here, scroll down a tiny bit, and then click here for download and support. And then scroll down a tiny bit more and then download DDU portable self-extracting or the installer, whichever you prefer. I'll download the portable one. So that'll download up here. And then I'll also go to NVIDIA.com to download our graphics drivers. Then up here, I'll click drivers. Then up here under the manual driver search, we make sure we select GeForce. And then here we'll select our series. We'll select the GeForce RTX 50 series. And right below that, we'll want to select what specific card. We're going to be using the NVIDIA GeForce RTX 5060 Ti because that's the GPU on the card itself. Then we'll select our operating system. I'm using Windows 11, so I'll select that. And then our language down here. I'm speaking English, so I'll select English and I'll click Find. And now we have a few options here. We have our GeForce Game Ready driver or our NVIDIA Studio driver. The studio driver is meant more for studios or workstations or at work, if anything, more professional than gaming. They're generally older drivers, but typically more stable. The Game Ready drivers are the newest batch that they have of drivers, which are meant to fix a lot of issues with games and give you more performance as well. As I mentioned, they're the newer drivers, so it's up to you which you prefer. Personally, I always go for the Game Ready drivers. All right, whichever you prefer, then you'll click on that over here, click View. And then select download to download it. Looks like it came out just 3 days ago. All right, now once that's done downloading, we'll want to click on the folder here to open up the folder, and we're going to extract DDU. So I'll double click on this file, and then we'll put it wherever you like, but I'd prefer to put it in the root of the drive under the folder DDU. Then I'll close out of here. I'll close out of everything. I'm going to hold the left shift key. Then I'm going to right click on the start button, shut down or sign out, and click restart. Now you can let go of the left shift key. Under choose an option, we'll select troubleshoot, then advanced options, startup settings, then finally restart to change Windows options such as, and we're going to be using safe mode. So here we'll select restart. So click here. Under startup settings, after a restart, we have a few options. We have number 4, which is enable safe mode, number 5, enable safe mode with networking, and number 6, enable safe mode with command prompt. Personally, I'd prefer to go with number 4, so I'll press number 4. Now, when we're in safe mode, we'll know we're in safe mode when we see on all four corners the word safe mode, or the phrase safe mode, and at the very top, the build version of our current version of Windows. I'm using Windows 11. Then here we'll select File Explorer, then scroll down a tiny bit, go to This PC and Local Disk C Drive and the DDU folder that we use for the installer, and then whatever version you have here. And then we double click Display Driver Uninstaller. This seems to be the first time you've launched DDU. Well, here, yeah. So we'll click OK here. Okay, you might want to resize this. It might be a little bit larger because you're in safe mode. So then here, under specific options, because we're coming from an NVIDIA card here, we'll select remove physics and leave unselected keep NVIDIA control panel because we want to remove the old control panel to install the new control panel. And now one thing you have to be very careful of here is AMD specific options. If you have an AMD chipset or if you have an AMD CPU, you're going to want to uncheck everything here. Having checks there, once you start the removal process, it'll remove those chipset drivers and it'll cause you to lose performance. Mind you, you can always reinstall or install the latest chipset drivers, but this way to keep your performance. and that way you won't have any particular issues. And then scroll down a tiny bit more. If you have an Intel CPU, you're going to want to remove all these checks here. I don't, so I'll just place a check everywhere here. And then under Advanced Options, make sure that you have a check where it says Prevent Downloads of the Drivers from Windows Updates when Windows search for a device, and click Close. So now here, select Device Type. We want to select GPU because we're removing a graphics card, and then select whatever graphics card you have. I'm removing an NVIDIA card, this card right here. If I was removing an AMD card, I'd select AMD, or if I was removing an Intel card, I'd select Intel. Again, I'm removing NVIDIA. So what we're doing here in safe mode is we're removing the old drivers. They could be drivers for a graphics card or for your CPU graphics. If you're using AMD graphics or Intel graphics, those are using graphics drivers. So regardless of that, DDU removes those drivers. Now, the reason we do this in safe mode is in regular Windows mode, Windows has a hold on those graphics drivers. It doesn't like to let go. So what happens is when you remove them in regular Windows mode, it leaves a lot of residue behind, a lot of junk. Sometimes even the uninstaller isn't the greatest, and it on its own leaves a lot of drivers and software behind, which causes issues on your graphics drivers installs. So that's what this is going to fix. It's going to leave you a clean slate, a foundation. This way you get better performance, better graphics, less blue screens, and less overall issues. But anyway, let's keep going. So since we're going to be uninstalling the drivers, then installing the new card, we're going to select Clean and Shutdown. And this will only take a few seconds. I did want to mention that everything shown in this video is listed down below with an Amazon affiliated link. And if you're grabbing any Corsair gear from Corsair.com, make sure to use coupon code ThisBytesForYou for 10% off your entire purchase. Now back to the video. So now we're just going to disconnect all of the cables, all the USB, and maybe we'll leave these because it'll be a little bit more difficult, and we'll disconnect the HDMI cable, and we'll also disconnect the power. Now let's go ahead and move the PC to a spot that we can actually remove the card. So before you touch anything inside of the computer, you're going to want to ground yourself. The way you ground yourself is by touching any metal portion of the case, not the motherboard or the graphics card, but like this over here on the case itself, a metal portion, preferably something that is not painted. That way you get more direct contact with the metal or with the steel. In this case, and a lot of other cases, you don't have a choice. So just touch a piece of metal over here. And whether the power supply is plugged in or not, because no matter what, if you touch a piece of metal and you have ESD, you're gonna zap it. Here you're zapping the case, not the components. So now with that said, we're going to want to remove the PCIe cable. So some of the clips may be at the bottom. In this particular card, it's at the very top. This clip is holding the card in place. To raise that clip, what we do is we push down on this piece of plastic here, and that raises the clip that's retaining it. So we push down here and then we pull the PCIe cable out. Easy enough, right? Now, along the rear of the case, we're going to want to remove the screws holding the card in place. In my case, it's the second and the third screw. So we'll just unscrew it here. All right, now that we've removed that, coming along over here, we're going to remove the card. Now, we just don't pull it out because we'd end up damaging it. There's a locking mechanism on the PCIe slot. Let me show you how to remove it. On this particular board, the MSI B850 Tomahawk Wi-Fi, there's a little button right over here that we simply push. That releases the card. So all we need to do is just pull it out. Really simple. Let me show you what it looks like on more traditional boards. On older or maybe more traditional boards, here would be your older graphics card or your newer card, and then your RAM here, your CPU here, rear I/O here. Along the top of the card, you might find a locking mechanism like this. Now what you do here is you push down on it, and you'll notice the card lift up a little tiny bit, and now you can remove that graphics card. And on those same systems, when you install your new card, what you push down before to unlock the card, that will automatically lock in place. A locking the card in place. So yeah, over time, they've made it a ton easier. So now let's go ahead and install the MSI VENTUS 2X GeForce RTX 5060 Ti. Just in case, the card comes with a cover over the PCIe fingers. Before you attempt to install it, just make sure you remove it, which reveals the gold PCIe fingers. As a side note, you may prefer to install the graphics card with the system laying on its side rather than the standing up like I do. I do it because it's a little bit easier to record that way. And being that I used to do this professionally, we always stood up rather than sitting down. So it's kind of ingrained in my head. So what we're going to do is just grab the card and slide it right over here. As you're sliding it in, make sure that these metal prongs don't stick out of here when you're sliding it in. Make sure they go in between the case and the motherboard. And make sure that these gold fingers go into this PCIe slot. So we'll slide it right into here. And that slides right into place. And you may also hear a little clicking sound letting you know that the button or the retention mechanism has snapped into place. Then coming around the back over here, let's go ahead and screw that graphics card in real quick. Now, like we removed the PCIe connection, we're going to want to put it back in. You could either use a 6+2 connection, or you can use an 8-pin PCIe cable that comes from your power supply. So then we'll just put them together here if you have a 6+2 or straight 8. Then we'll slide it right into the slot and you'll notice this little tab will go over the retention mechanism and click in place. You'll hear a click. Now you can just pull on it a tiny bit and the PCIe cable isn't going anywhere. Now we're done installing the graphics card physically. Let's go ahead and install the drivers real quick. So now on the back of your PC for your HDMI or DP cable, whatever you're going to use, if you came from onboard video, meaning graphics from your CPU, you're not going to plug it here anymore. You're going to plug it in the graphics card right over here. So we'll plug that in. Now you can plug in all the rest of your cables. And now we'll plug in the power cable. Now just make sure if it's on O, that's off. If it's on I, that's on, also stands for Iggy. So we'll select that for on. Now we're gonna turn it on for the first time. So I'll just press here. Now, just in case, we'll start tapping the delete key to go into the BIOS. Okay, so in the BIOS, there's going to be a few settings we need to make sure for this card since it is a UEFI card. First off, now it may cause issues if you're coming from CSM, but if you're coming from CSM, this video here will show you how to change all your settings so you could still boot into Windows. Okay, so I'm going to go into advanced mode, which I'm in now. In advanced mode, and this is going to be different on different BIOSes, but everything will be relatively the same. We'll come down here to boot. Then we want to make sure again, we're under UEFI here. We'll see boot mode selected, UEFI. The other option is CSM, and we definitely don't want that. And the other option would be under advanced. You see how here we can select UEFI or CSM. Again, make sure you're under UEFI. And then under PCIe subsystem settings, under ASPM controlled for CPU PCIe, for NVIDIA cards, we click on here and then click disable. So we want to make sure we disable ASPM for NVIDIA graphics cards, since having it enabled can introduce latency and lead to stability issues, even crashes again on NVIDIA cards. And then we'll select F10 to save and exit, and yes. Now that we're in Windows, we're going to click on File Explorer. Then we're going to go to the Downloads folder where we downloaded the latest graphics drivers. And then we're going to double click on them to install them and click OK here. And then we select Agree and Continue. This way it installs the graphics drivers and the NVIDIA app. Or if you only want the drivers, select that here, but I want both. Then I select Agree and Continue. And then I always select custom, that way I know what I'm installing, and then select next. Here I can select or deselect what I want, but I'm gonna leave everything here. And I'm also going to place a check under perform a clean installation. Even though we DDU'd the system, this is a double check, and then we click next. This will only take a few seconds. And then we can either leave create desktop shortcut for an NVIDIA app and launch NVIDIA app, or we can unselect them. So I'll unselect launching the app for now and click close. And now 1 second, let me switch the cable so that we can go directly from the card and not the capture card. 1 second. So now talking about switching between the capture card and the graphics card, when I'm recording all this other stuff, I'm using my capture card to capture all the screens. Now, I have to use my graphics card so that I can show you all the proper graphics setting. Now, for performance sake, we'll right-click on the background and then select Show More Options, and then we'll select Display Settings. Under Display Settings, we'll scroll down and we'll go to Advanced Display. Then we want to make sure it's always wrong under Choose a Refresh Rate that you have your highest refresh rate possible for your particular monitor. So mine is 120 Hertz. So select 119.99. Let me know what your refresh rate is down below. So we'll click that there and then click Keep Changes. So now we can close out of here. And again, we'll right click on the background and we'll select Show More Options. And then we'll select NVIDIA Control Panel. Agree and continue here. And now here we're going to want to select Setup GSync if your monitor supports GSync or FreeSync like mine does. And if it's not already checked, place a check right over here. And then I like to do enable for full screen mode rather than a window. Also, in case your monitor doesn't truly support GSync like mine actually supports FreeSync, I always place a check here, enable settings for the selected display model. And again, it's not there, but I like to do that just in case, and I click apply. Now by raising the refresh rate, our games are going to be a little bit smoother. And then also with GSync, our games are going to be a lot smoother. Now, if you wanted to, I don't because the default settings are great. We can come under adjust image settings with preview, and then we can come down here and we can either select let the application decide, use advanced 3D image settings, or select use preferences emphasizing quality. And then maybe we don't care about the quality so much as performance. Slide it down and click apply. Again, I'm happy with the way it goes there, but for advanced 3D image settings, we'll click take me there here. And then we have a lot more granular settings that we can select here. Again, NVIDIA's done a good job with these settings. I leave them alone, but if you needed more, you can here. And then under program settings, if you want to add specific profiles or settings for particular games or maybe an application, I'll click down here. And then I'll look around for any games or any applications that my system uses that I might want to get better performance out of. So here we can see a lot of the games we have already installed, but I'm not seeing anything there. Maybe scroll down a tiny bit. Anything I want to change because it's going to work great. And later on, I can change things if I want to. But maybe I want to play with the software that I'm recording the screen with. I'll click Add here. And then I'm using Wondershare Filmora, select that, and then click Add Selected Program. So now we can see all of these settings are for that application. And I can change whatever I want to here to get better performance from that application. So that's just another way to eke out some extra performance. And then lastly, configure surround, physics, and all that stuff. Would I like to change settings? I didn't change anything I care about, so no for now. But you would select yes if you made a change. And then here you can enable displays with surround or surround configuration for multiple monitors. And then here you can either move the physics to your graphics card or to your CPU. In case your graphics card isn't as powerful as it should be, you move it to CPU, but auto does good on its own. And then if you had any changes, you'd scroll down and click apply and okay. I've taken you from your old graphics card, removing your old graphics card, to installing your brand new graphics card, and then installing your drivers, and then optimizing Windows performance, and then actually getting more performance out of your games if you wanted to. So now at this point, you can start gaming. You can start rendering or editing video. You can start doing whatever it is you want to do with your PC. And if you'd like to see how this card stacks up against the 9060, the 9070, even the 4060, don't forget to check out this video up above. This is Iggy with ThisBytesForYou showing you how to install the MSI VENTUS 2X GeForce RTX 5060 Ti. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou up. See you guys.